Thank you. Thank you. everyone. Oh. We're gonna break this down. That's okay. Hello, 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 hello. Ow! Hello, hello. Okay, we're here. Then we run across to here. This is good. And then we run across to here. And this is good. Hello. Yeah? Okay. Oh, sorry. Hi everyone, my name is Rose. It's spelled. Oh.
Whoa!
Hello, test 1, 2.
Bibbidi bobbidi 1, 2, 3.
Hello.
see trees that are green, red roses too. I watch them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, the people passing by.
I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do?
But they're really saying, I love you.
The people passing by.
Let me bring it together. Time for a brand new start. We're gonna put it in motion. Down what keeps us apart. No more, no division. We down. New team, get the vision. Unite.
You can't live in my dream. In life, on to Monday, like I'll see you. You see me.
Thank you. welcome to Donvale Primary School Grade 6 graduation for 2020. We'd like to begin by acknowledging the Wurundjeri people, traditional custodians of the land which we gather on today, and pay our respects
to elders past, present and emerging. We extend that respect to Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders peoples here tonight.
For those who don't know, we are the captains and vice-captains of Donvale Primary School in 2020. What an incredible year it has been, and although it was not quite how we pictured it would be, it's amazing to be standing up here, knowing that we made it.
It's fantastic to see all of our families here, celebrating with us, and it's amazing to know that our extended families and friends are watching from home. It's also great to see all the staff here, who have each played a role in guiding us towards this moment.
An enormous amount of planning and preparation has gone into the ceremony that you're about to see, and we really hope you enjoy it. We are going to start with the students from 56T reflecting on their special memories from Donvale. This will be followed by a presentation of their graduation certificate. Welcome, 56T.
Finally, it was time to have some extreme fun on camp. I was walking up to the giant swing with my helmet and harness on, ready for some fun.
The instructor put a rope around me and I was lifted up into the air. Everyone in my group then said 3, 2, and they all stopped there. Without anyone even saying 1, the instructor pulled the rope and I started flying. I went from side to side really, really fast. From that day forward, I've been scared sick of giant swings.
In grade 4, my friends and I were tasked with getting iPads from the storage room. To make things interesting, we snuck around to avoid detection. Once we had what we needed, I pretended to radio for a chopper. Then an actual military-grade helicopter appeared in the sky. This is my favorite memory of Donvale.
I never thought that you could turn into a snowman, but here I am telling you how. 4 years ago, at camp at NAC, I was putting on some sunscreen since it was a really hot day. When I turned around, my whole cabin burst out laughing. I didn't know why, so I just laughed with them. Then one of the girls said, "You look like a snowman." I looked at myself in the mirror, and she was right. I did look like a snowman. I'll never forget that day.
I remember this so distinctly like it was yesterday. It was my birthday! But not just any ordinary birthday. We were at Camp Adenap. I was packing my humongous suitcase when suddenly an emergency meeting was called. I was sitting quietly when a delicious cake was revealed. I thought it was a goodbye cake, but boy was I wrong. It was for me! I must have eaten at least half the cake because I skipped the whole lunch. This is my favourite Donvale memory.
Do you know what it means to say, if you don't know how to spell a word, you sound it out? Well, one time in prep, I was writing my Greek and Wigan about how I went to KFC, until I realised I couldn't spell KFC. Till this day, it has been a funny moment for me.
In round robin 2019, I did rounds. It was the last game for the day and we were all tired. I was on the bench for that game, and I was waiting for the game to finish. Out of the corner of my eye, I found a plastic bag floating up in the middle of the air. For some reason, it just went up. To this day, I still wonder if the plastic bag is still going up.
One of my favorite memories at Donvale is at Camp 2019, specifically the disco. After the DJ hit play and the music started rolling, everyone danced and sung to the music crazily. This is one of my favorite memories because of all the sheer fun we had that day.
I will never forget production 2019 when I got my first solo. It was a solo, but it was embarrassing. The section the 5/6s were doing for production was the School of Rock. And if you have seen the movie, yes, I'm the girl who had to sing terribly. When I stood up and sang, my face went as red as a tomato. But it was still the best production I've done at Donvale.
2017 cross country. I remember it like it was just yesterday. I was tied for the first five on my way to win, but it was just too late. I was ready to give up. It would take a miracle to win, and then it happened. I slipped onto some mud, slipped past my competitor over the finish line. It was just like I was flying, right before I tumbled down laughing with tears. This is my most memorable memory of Donvale, the laughs I shared and the mess I was covered in.
Last year at recess, Sam and I were having a competition to see who could stand the spinnies the longest. A few people decided to join us, one of them being a girl with dark brown hair and brown eyes. I found out that her name was Tiffany. After a few competitions, Tiffany and I started to talk. That was the day I met my best friend. Donvale Primary is a very good place to make friends.
Can I please invite Mrs. Clark and Mr. McKinley up to the stage to present the students from 516 with their graduation certificates as they officially graduate from Donvale Primary School. As I read the students' names, you will see a presentation that each student has created to represent their friends and their interests. Up first in 516, we have Chris Bradnance. Chris is one of the most bright students I've ever taught. During online learning, we found out that he is a good quiz master, winning many of our afternoon quizzes. I'm going to miss our discussions on everything from weather to history. Good luck at Lawn College, Chris. Next, can I invite Chris Fraser? Chris is one of those students who absorbs anything history related. I'm going to miss our conversations about everything from the Crusades to the World Wars. As you move into high school, I hope you keep up this quest for knowledge and history. All the best as you move to East Doncaster Secondary College. Can I please invite up Anas Kuridashi? Anas has had a great year in 2020. She clearly was happy to be around her friends again when we came back to school. Anas can be quite accident prone. She often comes in after class and says, "Mr. Tapper, I fell again." Keep up the good work, Lawn College team. Next we have James Kavanagh. As many of you know, James is a born entertainer. He's surprised me many times this year with his impressive creativity. James's Book Week costume is one I and many others will not easily forget. Good luck as you move into high school. I'm sure I'll see you on TV in the not too distant future. Good luck at all college teams. Can I next invite up Tiffany Lee? Tiffany is a student I've had the pleasure to teach for the last 2 years. In that time, Tiffany has grown into a confident and polite student who always tries her hardest. You may not know, but Tiffany is an impressive swimmer. Who knows? Maybe one day we'll see her at the Olympics. Best of luck at Doncaster Secondary College next year. Up next, we have Noah Lochisano. Noah has had a great year despite all of our interruptions. He and I clearly have a similar sense of humour, and it was great to have someone in the class who appreciates sarcasm as much as I do. Noah smashed it during remote learning. He loved getting all of his work done early, so he could spend his time doing what he really wanted to do, which was playing online games. Good luck at Lawn College next year, mate. Can I invite up Nicholas Mancy? I would also like to say buongiorno to Nick's father, who is watching this live from Italy as we speak. Nick is a kind and loyal student who has had a great year in 2020. Nick has a great sense of humour and many times has had a whole class laughing. Good luck at Doncaster Secondary College. Up next we have Charlotte Martin. 2 years. Two very long years I've taught Charlotte. But in all seriousness, I'll miss all the fun we've had in that time. Charlotte is a kind, thoughtful, and capable student who has made an impression on many of the students and staff at Donvale. Keep smiling and being your happy self as you move into Year 7 at Catholic Ladies College. Next we have Chris Nunn. If we gave out awards for bleeding noses, then Chris would be hands down. Chris is a very impressive writer, and I wouldn't be surprised if one day I pick up one of your books from a bookstore. Keep working hard, mate, and good luck in these Doncasters every time. Last but not least, we have Robin Solomon. Robin is another student who I've had the pleasure of teaching for the last 2 years. In this time, Robin has grown into another confident and enthusiastic student who loves to learn new things. Some of you may not know, but Robin is an up-and-coming cricketer. Who knows, one day we might see him in the WBBL. Best of luck at Lyon College next year, Robin. I present to you the 2020 graduating class of 516. Can you take your seats as I welcome the grade 6s from 5-6S to share their Donvale memories with you.
I remember in year one, we were doing our production and Tam asked me to do a role. that didn't include speaking. So, being me, I said yes. Little did I know, I had to stand up in front of everyone and get my character's name called out. On the night, I stood up and my legs gave way. Yes, I fell face first onto the stage. My friends and I still laugh about it till this day.
I remember last year, my class was in our room and Mr. Tuttle was reading our class book. I looked at Cooper, so I'm eating the skin of his banana, so I thought it was a good idea to try myself. I took a big bite and seconds later I realised it was a horrible idea. I quickly ran to the bin and spat it out. After that day, I never ate the skin of a banana again.
I remember like yesterday. I was signing for the giant swing as I quickly approached the front of the line. Next minute, I had a helmet on my head and I was in the air. People the size of ants below me counted down. 3, 2, 1. I dropped. This is one of the best memories of my life.
Going back to camp last year, it was getting late and everyone in my cabin were whispering quietly when we heard a noise coming from our window. Amy said it was probably just the teachers, so we ignored it and kept whispering. But then, all of a sudden, we heard Mr. Tapper come through our window and say, "It is the teachers!" We all screamed and then started laughing. This is definitely one of my favourite moments at Donvale.
Thank you, students, for those wonderful memories. I'm now going to invite Mrs. Clark and Mr. McKinley back to the stage to help me formally present these students with their graduation certificates as they officially graduate from Donvale Primary School. Which has come in very handy in 2020. He is a fantastic swimmer and has won races against kids much older than he is. His same determination that makes him a great swimmer also makes him a fantastic student. I know that he will be very successful as he heads off to Kenan College next year. Could I please call Riley Edwards to the stage? Riley has been a fantastic school captain through a very challenging year. He has really gained confidence while speaking at assemblies, both online and face-to-face, and he is doing a fantastic job tonight, as are all the captains. Riley excels not just in the classroom, but in sports as well. He is well-liked by everyone in our class, and I am positive that he will be very successful when he heads off to Whitefriars next year. Can I please call Allie Irwin? Allie has been a delight to teach this year. Her fun, unique personality makes her a standout from the crowd. She may come across as quiet, but she definitely has a cheekiness that comes out when you get to know her. She is a fantastic basketball player who can often be seen out on the courts. If anyone needs any tips, go and see her. It has been a pleasure teaching Allie this year, and I wish her all the best for her transition to Doncaster High School next year. Rose Franklin. Rose has really found her shell this year. She began 2020 as a quiet and reserved student, but she really found her stride during remote learning. Rose has proven that she can do anything she puts her mind to. She decided to put her energy into improving in math. She worked hard and she did just that. She loves singing and is obsessed with K-pop. I know that she will be successful in whatever she chooses to do. Best of luck in Lana for next year. Please call Hayden Fraser next. It's been my absolute pleasure teaching Hayden this year. I would like to say that he is a sensible and respectful young man, but he did fall through a roof during remote learning, so I'm not sure sensible is the correct word to use. Obviously, we are delighted that he is okay. Hayden has been a fantastic sports captain, a wonderful friend, and a well-liked member of our class. Hayden, I wish you all the best at Blackburn High School next year, but please keep both feet on the ground at all times. Dale Lamana. Sometimes the kids who challenge you the most are the ones that you end up liking the most. Dale, when I look at you, I see a great kid with so much potential. It is a great joy to watch you interact with your buddy and the younger students at Donvale Primary School. This is when your compassion and empathy really shine through. I actually can't imagine a day at Donvale Primary that doesn't have you in it. I am truly going to miss you. Best of luck at Doncaster next year. I hope you will come past and let me know how you're going when you're picking up Isabella from school. My door is always open. Abby Oldham. I've been privileged to watch Abby grow and blossom this year. Abby's cheery personality has brightened my days. At the start of the year, I'm pretty sure that Abby may have lost her head if it wasn't attached to her shoulders. So we decided that 2020 was the year that Abby was going to get her life together. Well done, Abby, on getting it together. You have had a fantastic final year at Donvale Primary. Best of luck at Doncaster for next year. Please call up Peter Terranides. Pete is definitely the life of the party. I can't count the number of times Pete has cracked me up in class. His energy has kept me on my toes and wildly entertained all year. I will miss his energy and enthusiasm next year. Best of luck at Doncaster. I hope I see you and the family up bike riding so we can catch up soon. Can I please call Lexi Williams? Lexi has shown amazing resilience through a very challenging year. In the last few weeks, I've had the pleasure of watching her blossom into a happier, more confident young lady. Lexi has a passion for script writing and directing, and I hope that I get an invite to her first production. We have shared a lot of laughs this year and a few tears. I will miss her exuberance and positivity for life. Best of luck at Eltham High School next year. And last but never least, Ruby Young. Ruby is who I aspire to be when I grow up. Throughout remote learning, she would get up early, do her yoga, get started on her learning, and rock up to her WebEx meetings with a smoothie, looking refreshed and fabulous. It has been an absolute joy teaching Ruby this year. She has a mature and positive attitude towards learning and life in general. I will miss having Ruby's energy in class with me every day. You'll be greatly missed at Donvale Primary School. Blackburn High School is gaining a wonderful student next year. I present to you the 2020 graduating class of 5-6S. Grade 6s to take their seats, and the 5-6T and 5-6S parents, if we could ask you to leave now via the kitchen. Thank you. As you're moving around, we are going to set up a video for you to watch. We've had a wonderful time watching your children grow up, and you may not realize how much they've changed over the years. 5-6T and 5-6S parents, your children will feature last in the video, okay? So you should have some time to make your way back to your designated viewing room in the middle building. Once the video has concluded, could the families from 56W and 56R make their way to the senior building as quickly as possible? So you're welcome to start moving in. The video will be made available to the kids over the next few days so they can download a copy at school and keep it if you wish. So sit back, relax, and enjoy. Thank you.
swapped it on our phone outside. It's perfect. It's just in the room. Sorry,
Thank you.
in the front row. But I'm going to ask you guys now to move back to your seats and wipe those tears away. And the students from 5-6W can come up to the stage to share your reflections.
School was at 2019 return. When everyone was packing up after the fun day, Mr. Tapper came in the building with a basketball. We all thought he was just going to shoot through, so he went to the middle of the court. Everyone had no idea what he was doing, but then one person said, "Let's go, Tapper, let's go." And then we all started saying it. And then he finally leaped in the air, threw the ball as hard as he could, swish, it went in. The crowd went super crazy. I will always cherish this memory of Donvale Primary School.
And that's the best of my life I'll never forget. Thank you. and the song I performed at the Phillip Island Beach Camp, Donvale Idol, was Don't Stop Me Now. Everyone laughed, and it was very popular. I'd also love to thank the teachers that supported me through Donvale Primary School, and I can't wait to high school and get some new friends and memories.
My best memory in Donvale Primary School is when I won the Tuesday Trivia in Great Bike Camp. We were split into teams of four. During the second round, I was promoted to the finals and went up against Patrick. The question was, is the mascot in Camp Rocker named Dude? Patrick and I both said no, but I made a last minute change to yes. I won. It was an awesome experience for me. She has led our school with grace and maturity and with the maturity of somebody well beyond her years, consistently searching for ways to make people happy. Emily gives her absolute all in everything she does, and I've even had the pleasure of watching her shine on stage. The sadness of knowing that she's leaving us is only cushioned by the fact that she has to come back to visit her two little sisters. And when that happens, I can't wait to hear all about how successful you've been. Congratulations, Emily. Next up, we have Ethan Cowell. Ethan is a really friendly student who shows great loyalty to his friends. His kindness and patience shine through during our buddy sessions where he was a great buddy to little Anton. Ethan has a great sense of humour and loves to make others laugh. Although he's faced lots of challenges, I'm really proud of you for pushing through right until the end. Congratulations, Ethan, and good luck at Malone next year. For the past 2 years. Over that time, I've seen him make so much growth and start to become a real young gentleman. Max has always been the first to hold the door open and the last to hang around after the bell just to say goodbye. He has such a sweet nature and always managed to put a smile on my face. Max is going to do wonders when he attends Malone next year, and I can't wait for you to visit and tell me all about it. Good on you, Max. On my birthday, something I didn't think I'd even mentioned at school, but Barney remembered because that's the kind of person she is. Quite often this year, it felt like Barney had her life more sorted out than mine, and I could always count on her to remind me of things I'd forgotten or to undertake an important job. Your thirst for learning and endless enthusiasm will certainly set you up for success when you attend Simon next year. Congratulations. Next, we have Martin Katibieka. Martin is one of the kindest people I have ever met. The way he thinks of others before himself is truly admirable, and it will take him far in life. I remember earlier this year during a W Buck auction, Martin knew one of his classmates couldn't afford a prize that they really, really wanted, so he spent a large amount of his own W Bucks just to win that prize and give it to his classmate. I'm so lucky to have known such a beautiful soul, and the community of White Friars would love to have you next year. Congratulations. Next we have Georgia Leofis. quiet achiever this year. She's a no fuss, no job is too hard type of kid who always gives her best effort. Georgia is a much loved member of our class and has many friends who love her dearly. She's been a superstar big buddy to Tsunami, her patience and compassion shining through. Congratulations, Georgia. Good luck at Doncaster next year. Next we have Layla Lishimura. Layla said had an interesting start here at Donvale. The students in our class first met Layla via WebEx, but that didn't stop Layla becoming a much-loved friend and a superstar student. Nothing is too much trouble for Layla. She's respectful, responsible, and always gives 110%. You will have seen, and will see again, how she absolutely nails these graduation dances, a true testament to her dedication and attitude. You've had an awesome time with us, Layla. I'm only sad that we didn't get to have you for a little bit longer. Congratulations and good luck at SIAN next year. Next we have Nella Orman. At our school we talk a lot about gratitude, and if there's one student that's the poster child for it, it's Nella. Nella's happiness is contagious, and when she walks into that room with that big smile on her face, you just can't help but smile back. She always has a positive attitude and forever reminds us how lucky we are to have the facilities, equipment, and opportunities that we do. Nella works really hard for others and never asks for anything in return. She's been an incredible member of our class this year, and Doncaster Secondary is lucky to have you. Well done, Nella. Next we have Maurice Smiley. I have had the absolute pleasure of teaching Maurice for the past 2 years, and during that time he has shown incredible growth. He always endeavours to put a smile on everyone's faces, whether it be from a compliment, a funny meme, or a classic Rickroll during online learning. He is always looking for new ways to make life fun. I'm so proud of how far you've come, Maurice, and the resilience you've shown when facing challenges. Everyone at Donvale is going to miss you, and I hope you come back and tell us all about your success at Wilmona College. Well done. And lucky last 56W, we have Brandon Young. I still remember the first day when Brandon came to Donvale. When children come to a whole new school in a whole new country, you expect them to be a little bit shy or overwhelmed, but not Brandon. He's confident, chatty, and enthusiastic right from the get-go. He's highly respectful and responsible and a much-loved member of our class. I have watched his confidence continue to grow and have seen him achieve some really impressive things over the last 2 years. He's a maths wizard, a hard worker, and just a really friendly kid. Congratulations, Brandon. I'm sure you'll be successful at any time. Present to you the 2020 graduating class of 56W.
This is my best memory at Donvale Primary School. Me and my friends in year prep, all through to year four, made a club called the Wolfie Club. The Wolfie Club is about dogs. Every recess and lunchtime, we would talk about dogs. We loved it. I'll never forget this memory.
My years at Donvale Primary brought memories of all kinds, but one of the most memorable things happened on grade three camp. One of the activities I was particularly looking forward to was canoeing. Unfortunately, when we started, my partner and I were struggling and kept going round in what seemed like endless circles. After a while, I finally got the hang of it, but then my partner tried to copy me. She accidentally stood up, flipping the canoe and throwing both of us into the freezing cold lake water. We were drenched from head to toe. Even though we were freezing, we were laughing out loud.
My anecdote is based in 2016 when I was in year two. This was the year because I had five teachers. We started off with Mrs. Jones and Mrs. Signorini as our teachers. However, after one term, they sadly both left for family reasons. Mr. McKinley and Mrs. Richardson then stepped in. Mr. McKinley stood up for the role while they found us a second teacher. Mrs. Wright then teamed up with Mrs. Richardson for the duration of the year. This is by far the most puzzling year in my Donvale experience.
My favourite year of Donvale Primary School would have to be at Waratah Bay Beach Camp 2019. One of my best friends named John Murphy was attempting the activity while holding a bucket of muddy water. While attempting the activity, he ended up spilling a whole bucket of muddy water over himself and I and the rest of our friends in our room. We ended up both bursting into tears of laughter, and I always want to remember this memory.
It was the second day of camp in 2017, and it was my turn to go down the 100-metre water slide. I was terrified. I remember Mrs. Hodgins trying to get me to go down, and Mr. Hogg motioning for me to come forward from the water trampoline. Eventually, I agreed to go. I sat down, and then I was off. After I finished my turn, I realised how fun going down the water slide was, and decided to go again and again until it was time to go on the slide. I will never forget how proud I was of myself.
Mr. Tapper was in a hulk suit while everyone else was just their favourite book character. This 2 o'clock meeting was dedicated to us having fun and talking about why we like these characters from these books. It was so much fun listening to everyone's opinions, and it changed my opinions of the book characters as well. This is the first book week I've ever been to, and probably the only one that I'll ever enjoy.
The time at Donvale that I remember the most was at grade 5 camp. There was a giant swing and I knew I had to go on it. I have always been too scared to go to the top. All my friends cheered for me as I was going up. As I was going up to the top, I felt relaxed. Until I reached the top, then I felt scared. When everyone started counting down, I felt alive. I looked down to see some cows in the paddock smiling at me. Suddenly, I dropped, and so did my stomach. When that was over, I realized that I've overcome my fear. What a great memory.
To invite Mrs. Clark and Mrs. McKinley back up to the stage to help me formally present the 5-6R students with their graduation certificates as they officially graduate from Donvale Primary School. Okay, first up for 5-6R is Ashton Browning. Ashton is a sensitive student who has loved helping out around the school this year. Of course, being away in remote learning has been tough for Ashton, as it has been for everyone, and I'd like to commend all the students on how well they coped with such a difficult year. Since coming back in Term 4, he's loved catching up with all his friends, and especially with his buddy Sam and all the other little kids. Clearly, Ashton is a big hit with the younger students. Congratulations, Ashton, on making it through a very tough year, and I wish you all the very best at Blackburn next year. Next, we have Caitlin Fankhauser. Caitlin was my remote learning superstar, up early and working hard every day. She was our unofficial proofreader who, on the very rare occasions that our teachers made a little mistake with the online learning tasks, she would very politely let us know, usually before 8:30, so we could fix it up before anyone else noticed. Thank you, Caitlin. You've been a star, and we wish you all the best on the next. Next we have Lucas McGuire. What a year to be school captain. Despite the fractured year that we've had, Lucas has gone above and beyond to try and be the best school captain he could possibly be. Responsible, thoughtful, confident yet approachable, Lucas has been a star at the few assemblies that we've had, and of course at all of our WebEx meetings and assemblies online. His skills are certainly on display tonight, where he and the other captains are doing an outstanding job. A very capable and confident student, Lucas is going to smash it at White Prize next year. Congratulations, Lucas, and good luck. Next up, we have Micah Negri. Micah is a creative, clever student with a quick wit and a friendly personality. Micah has been a strong force in our classroom and around the school, with many students looking up to him. Always keen to put his hand up and contribute in class, I've really enjoyed his sense of humour and his willingness to join in. I truly believe Micah has massive potential, and I wish him all the best at Doncaster Secondary. Next we have Rosanna Satude. Rosanna is a classic example of your quiet achiever. Nothing faces her or seems to upset her. She goes about her business with no fuss or commotion, always producing great work, well organised, confident, comfortable. She's one of those students that you can have great confidence in. Also, being here with the Littlies, it's been an absolute pleasure being her teacher for the past 2 years. Well done, Rosanna, and good luck next year at Doncaster. Next we have Storm Talia. Storm only joined us at the start of this year at Donvale, and what a year to make a start. It has been wonderful getting to know Storm this year. Luckily we had almost a whole term with her at the start of the year before the first lockdown occurred and WebEx took over our lives. In her short time with us, she's made many great friends and built a lovely bond with her buddy. A very capable student with a quirky sense of humour. It's been a lot of fun having her in my class. Congratulations, Storm, and good luck at East Donny next year. And finally, we have Emily Yeoman. I've taught Emily for the last 2 years, and in all my years of teaching, I've never met a student who is so prepared to ask questions and seek help, a wonderful attribute which many students struggle with. Early on in our time together, I told Emily that the words, "I don't get it," were actually music to my ears because it allowed me the opportunity to provide clarity and to help her learn. She embraced this concept, and I truly thank her for that. Rarely do we ever see Emily without that beautiful big smile on her face. I knew it would be there. Congratulations, Emily, and good luck at Tintern next year. I present to you the 2020 graduating class of 5-6R. To rewrite the lyrics of a popular song to reflect the students' feelings about graduating from Donvale Primary. This year, a group of students approached us and asked us if they could have a go at it, and we're very proud of what they've come up with. Please join me in congratulating Barney, Emily, Amelie, and Caitlin for all the hard work they've put in creating a song that will be really special to these kids for many years to come. Following this performance, we're going to ask the 5-6R and 5-6W parents to leave the building by the kitchen and head back to the middle building. Without further ado, I'd like to welcome up the grade 6 students. Okay. now invite the parents to head back to the other building. Thank you. Stuff left, but hopefully all the parents over in the other buildings are able to see and hear us and take this all in. So, personally, I'd like to congratulate all the students on that fabulous performance. If you could put your hands together for me, please. As always, the graduation and production dances were choreographed by Tamlin Smith, who's trying to hide over in the corner here. He always does a fantastic job with the kids. The singers were trained by Kerry Gary, who always works with us on our State School Spectacular sessions. Both of these outside workers come into our school voluntarily, often to help people out, and they always get great results from the kids, stuff that us teachers couldn't possibly achieve. So can you please put your hands together for these two fabulous teachers? So, moving on to the next important part of the evening, the awards. Each year we acknowledge the grade 6 students who have done outstanding things in a number of fields. As the numeracy learning specialist, it is my responsibility to hand out the numeracy award for 2020. Numeracy in 2020 is a whole lot more than just adding up and subtracting. Students in grade 6 need to complete work in three areas: number and algebra, measurement and geometry, and statistics and probability. They need to be fluent in mathematics, and they need to be able to show mathematical reasoning, understanding, and problem-solving capabilities. It is a much different world of maths than when we went to school. As with most of the other awards, there were many students this year who could have been worthy winners. The person chosen has shown strength in all areas of numeracy, a thirst for furthering their knowledge, and importantly, a willingness to help others. I'm very pleased to announce that this year's winner of the Numeracy Award is Brandon Young. Next up is our Literacy Learning Specialist, Mrs. Rassias, who will present the award for literacy.
In writing, they plan, they compose, they edit, and they publish a range of text types, and engage their reader through their use of vocabulary and language features. And in speaking and listening, they consider and respond to the viewpoints of others, create convincing arguments, and lead their peers in group discussions. Again, this year there have been many students to choose from, however, they can only get one recipient. This year's recipient excels in all literacy, demonstrating critical and creative thinking, advanced vocab, and the ability to create music with words. And the Literacy Award for 2020 goes to Ruby Young.
Scientists hold the range of qualities that we foster and encourage here at Donvale Primary School. Good scientists are curious, always asking why and how things work the way they do. They are patient, conducting many trials and closely observing the world around them. They are persistent, resilient, and critical and creative thinkers. The student who receives this award each year consistently demonstrates each of the aforementioned qualities. They not only excel in their understanding of science, but their dedication and work ethic shines through when they participate in our science lessons. This year's recipient is highly thoughtful and always eager to learn about the world around them. They work meticulously to understand scientific concepts and consistently ask questions to further develop their understandings. I am proud to announce that this year, our Science Award goes to Christopher Brabants. like to welcome up Mr. Hogg, who will present the awards for ICT and BE. First off, the ICT Award. The Award for Information Communication Technologies is awarded to the Grade 6 student that over the course of their time at Donvale Primary has demonstrated effective use of information technology, as evidenced by their time on all different platforms such as desktops, laptops and iPads. The student must have demonstrated an innovative use of multimedia during their DQB sessions, used technology appropriately for use of communication, and displayed a willingness to assist others with their time using technology. The winner of the 2020 award has ticked all the boxes, and I'm proud to announce that Mateen Katiyekta is the winner of the Prime Minister's ICT Award. Sport Award at Donvale Primary School is named after Paul Roos, a man that has played and coached over 600 games of AFL football. He's a member of the Australian Football Hall of Fame. Paul, also as a child, attended Donvale Primary in the early 70s. In his first book, Paul Roos, Beyond 300, he states that Donvale Primary School is an ideal place to harness the love of sport. Despite all the hurdles that have affected the world in 2020, the class of 2020 has proven Roos once again correct. You cannot see a more committed group of young adults reaffirm their love of sport once we return to on-site teaching and learning. I've been lucky enough to teach these students weekly, and there are 29 of you that I've taught for 5 years. There are also 16 of you I've taught in the classroom, so it's a real privilege teaching each and every one of you, and I'm really proud of all of you. This year has been a really difficult one to award for a number of obvious reasons. After looking at the school values of responsibility, resilience, respect and compassion, and which students have best reflected these over the course of their time at DPS during sporting events, I came to the conclusion that this year's Paul Roos Sports Awards be awarded to Riley Edwards and Caleb Mayfield. Present the Performing Arts Board.
This year, the Vivian Doherty Performing Arts Award is awarded to someone with the following attributes: an obvious passion for the performing arts, including dance, music technology, and a willingness to have a go at a variety of instruments such as keyboard, ukulele, and marimba. All their assistants throughout the year are of a high standard, and they also demonstrate both skill and commitment to extracurricular activities such as our senior choir band and our marimba band. This year's winner has consistently displayed a positive attitude in class, has been willing to share their ideas, help others, and has shown quiet maturity when working in groups. They also model exemplary manners and a sense of gratitude. I'm absolutely delighted to announce that this year's Performing Arts winner is Caleb Mayfield. So I wish you all the best in secondary school, and I look forward to seeing where music takes her in the future. Now, unfortunately, Mrs. Stephanie is unwell tonight, so she sends her regards to you all, and in lieu of her award being presented, I ask Mr. McKinley to come and present that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. King. And Mrs. DeStefan has said that she really was disappointed that she wasn't here tonight. Like Mr. Hogg, she has taught you for the last 5 years, which I think would be since grade two, and she really has loved watching you develop all over those years. So thank you to Mrs. DeStefan for that message. Now, the 2020 Visual Arts Award. In the art room, we offer students, or Mrs. DeStefan does, an opportunity to engage with others through a visual language, build problem-solving skills, explore their worldview. Each year, the IRE Molson Visual Arts Award is given to a Year 6 student who embraces this opportunity, someone who independently experiments with a range of techniques and materials, clearly communicates ideas, evaluates, reflects on, and develops their work. This year, the award goes to a student who has approached each class with enthusiasm, participated in extension activities, showed a respectful and positive attitude in class, helped promote the art program, and demonstrated great skill. It gives Mrs. DeStefanis great pleasure to select Abigail Oldham. As the recipient of the 2020 Visual Arts Award.
Come and view then. Now.
Can I now invite Mr. Coe to the stage to present the Lode Award?
Recipient of the Mandarin Chinese Confucius Award this year demonstrated exceptional effort, enthusiasm, and initiative in Mandarin learning by being a role model for the rest of the class and the school. A high standard of speaking, listening, reading, and writing. An outstanding result and achievement of this year's Mandarin learning on oral and written tasks and assessments completed during on and off-site learning throughout the year. The winner of the very first Mandarin Confucius Award goes to someone who is highly inquisitive about learning Mandarin, embracing the Chinese culture and its people so positively. Without a doubt, the student has also demonstrated our school values in Mandarin class, respecting the teacher and others in a mature manner. I'm so excited to announce the winner of the 2020 Confucius Award goes to Lucas McGuire. I'd like to invite Mrs. Akla to come back to the stage to present the Principal's Award.
Okay, congratulations to all our recipients thus far. I'm very, very hard-earned and well-deserved. Children, I know you are very tired, but you are being extremely patient. I want to see you sitting up nicely. Always the principal. Thanks, everyone. Children, this award, and to all our parents that are viewing us at the moment, I'm so sorry that you can't be here because I know how important it is to be present, but we've done our best, and I hope that you're okay and that you are watching this with big smiles on your faces and very, very proud of you, because we are extremely proud of all of these children tonight. So I get the pleasure of presenting the Principal's Award. And unlike other awards, which are based on excellence in the academics, the arts, the sciences, the technologies, and the sporting fields, the Principal's Award is an acknowledgement of a student's demonstration of character and integrity. Someone who consistently demonstrates our school values, resilience, respect, responsibility, compassion, and gratitude. The one that we popped on, yes, at the end, over the last couple of years. So each year, and this year is no different, I struggle. I struggle enormously to choose that one child, because there are so many of you that deserve this. Just that one child that exemplifies the spirit of this award. In fact, this year in particular was very, very difficult. So, I've done this before, because I get very challenged by making a decision. This year again, I've decided to give my Principal's Award to two students. These students have just stood out, not only through the year, but throughout the years that they have been at Donvale Primary School. Both these children are the nicest and the kindest people I know. They're always friendly, they're considerate, they're rational, sensible. They demonstrate all our values as they go about their day-to-day goings-on of life, just being a school kid. They work and they try hard at all times, have high expectations, and have been exemplary role models to other students. I also have no doubt that both of these children will be most humble in accepting these awards. I know that great things are coming their way. So, I very proudly present this award, firstly, to our school vice-captain, Emily Bishop.
In this most unusual years, all leaders, at every age level, in every profession and workplace across the country, have been tested. And so has been the case with our very own school leaders at Donvale Primary School this year. In a special year for them, our leaders have to deal with the disappointment of missing out on some of the special privileges that come the way of our school leaders and captains. However, reinforcing the idea that leadership is more about caring for others rather than yourself, our school leaders show great resilience by regularly visiting classroom WebEx meetings across the school during remote learning. At these meetings, they read stories, ran quizzes, and told great jokes, all designed to lift the students' morale and create a wider and deeper connection across the school during a difficult time for all of us. To our leaders here, we say, very well done and thank you for your creative efforts, enthusiasm and school spirit. It was very much appreciated. If leadership is not a license to do less, the responsibility to do more, then our school leaders, through their actions this year, have followed this idea in an exemplary fashion. We have at Donvale this year been so fortunate to have had many fine leaders in a variety of roles, from school captains, house captains, art captains, SRC leaders, marimba band captains, and peer mediators. And I'd just like to run through those leadership roles. Our wonderful school captains, Sonia Kelsey, Lucas McGuire, ably backed up by our fantastic vice captains, Emily Bishop and Riley Edwards. Acacia house captains, Alexandra Williams, Caitlin Fankhauser, Oliver Moyes. Banksia house captains, Charlotte Martin, Nicholas Nancy, Chloe Cooper. Grevillea house captains, Eleanor Coe, Hayden Fraser, Noah Lochisano. Art captains, Abby Alden, Christopher Robinets. Choir captains, Caitlin Fankhauser, Emily Yeoman. Marimba band, Martin Katidieta, Nella Omniware. SRC, Ruby Young. And peer mediators, which involved all Year 6 students. You've often heard it said that you do not need to be wearing a badge to be a leader. And so I would like to acknowledge all our Year 6 students who have provided our younger students with such a positive role model and demonstrated so well our school values of respect, responsibility, resilience, compassion, and of course, the latecomer, gratitude. If you went for a leadership position and missed out, don't worry. Keep believing in yourself and keep putting your hand up as your time will come. It really is the long haul and you're just starting out. To those students who have been wearing a badge, I would say to you, always keep it in a safe place over the years and treasure it. May it inspire you and give you the confidence to seek out future leadership positions at high school, tertiary education and beyond. Above all, may it always serve as a reminder of the belief that your primary school had in your leadership capabilities at such a young age. To all the wonderful student leaders of 2020, I want to thank you for your efforts and wish you all the best in your future leadership aspirations. Please make welcome now our wonderful school captains of 2020, Barney Kelsey and Lucas McGuire.
Started as any other school captain, Mrs. Clark calling out my name to be school captain. I was honoured and excited for the year ahead. We had a very solid start to 2020, but it was interrupted by COVID-19 and all of a sudden we were remote learning. This was a big change from on-site learning for all of us. Instead of learning with our classmates, we were sitting at home with our parents, siblings and pets. For me, it was hard just transitioning, but once I got used to it, it was okay. During remote learning, we still had some school captain responsibilities. One of these included joining one class from each year level per week via Webex. We played games such as bingo and did drawings. I was also able to present awards. I enjoyed seeing the other kids from Donvale and keeping in touch even though we were all at home. I think part of this year was very good for me. As I'm going into high school, learning to manage my own timetable has made me more independent. Even though I enjoyed some aspects of remote learning, I would have much preferred to be at school, going to Uber aged care centres, going to leadership conferences, and carrying out other leadership responsibilities around the school. Even though I haven't had the opportunity to fully carry out all my school captain responsibilities this year, I have still developed many leadership capabilities, which I know I will be able to carry over to my time at secondary school. 2020 has definitely made me a stronger and more resilient person, and I am sure many of us have learned important skills that will help us during high school and into our futures. I don't think any of us will be forgetting 2020 anytime soon.
Yes, correct.
I would like to finish off by thanking Mrs. Clark and Mrs. McKinley for the opportunity of being school captain this year. I would also like to thank all the staff, teachers and community for the past 7 years. I have enjoyed every little moment of my time here. I also wish all my friends all the best for the future. Thank you.
Captain for 2020. Even though this year hasn't been anything like we imagined, I enjoyed every bit of it. Whether it was visiting all the classes on a WebEx, or filming an Anzac Day speech, or even just experiencing assembly on a WebEx. At first, the Friday rush of organizing assembly was all over the place, but as the year progressed, we figured it all out. I have grown stronger and more confident with public speaking, amongst many other things. This leadership role has taught me many things, but one important thing that I have learned is to embrace the moment. Finally, I'd like to thank all the staff and students here at Donvale who have made not only mine, but our time an enjoyable one. Thank you.
Those wonderful speeches, Barney and Lucas, very well done. Right. My job now is to recognise the contribution made by some wonderful families that are now leaving our school. In many ways, we like to think of our school community as one big family. This year, we will be saying goodbye to many families who have been such a valued part of our school community over a long period of time. Thank you. If the greatest gift parents can give their child is love, then the provision of a good education must surely sit firmly in second place. There is no better way of showing your child how much you value their education than to be involved in it. And this year, all parents through remote learning have found themselves heavily involved in their children's learning. From working in classrooms, selling icy poles at the canteen, it's always popular, attending working bees, being a member of school council and the various subcommittees, or the hard-working parents association, coaching basketball teams, helping out on excursions, or simply being there to offer an encouraging smile to your child as they run past you in the school cross country. There are many ways to participate in your child's schooling, and the members of the families leaving have covered all of them. We couldn't offer the breadth of programs we do without your assistance. It plays a vital role in supporting and sustaining the positive Donvale primary school community culture that we are all so proud of. I would now like to formally acknowledge and thank the following families for their wonderful contribution to our school, their unwavering support and enthusiasm for all things DPS. The Browning family, Ashton, the Fankhauser family, Caitlin and brother Andrew, the Negri family, Micah and brothers Jai and Kyan, the Yeoman family, Emily and brother Oscar, the Fraser family, Hayden and sister Ashley, the Oldham family, Abby and brother Lachlan, the Taranitas family, Peter and sister Anastasia and brother George, the Young family, Ruby and brothers Brandon and Liam, another Fraser family, this time Christopher, Karimi Dashi, Anes, Kavanagh family, James and sister Stephanie, the Lochisano family, Noah and brother Luca, the Mansi family, Nicholas, the Cale family, Ethan and sister Jessica and brother Jackson, Kelsey family, Barney and sister Parvat, Katipi Yekta family, Martin and brother Amin, Leophis family, Georgia and brother Nathan, and last but not least, the Smirelli family, Maury. As we always say, it's not goodbye, just thanks until we see you again, and it goes without saying that you are always welcome back. I would now like to welcome Mrs. Clark to the stage to present her principal's address.
Okay, we're nearly there. All right, so now this is really weird. It's actually too weird. I'm so used to presenting to the students and to all of our parents, so again, sadly, it's not to be this year, but I know you're there somewhere and you're watching, and as I said earlier on, I certainly hope you are enjoying this evening. So, good evening, and thank you for this opportunity for me to say some brief words, and congratulations to you guys, all of our graduating students of 2020. So I want to welcome you all, and I want to welcome all the families and all the friends that are at home, that are some I know that are overseas, and there are some over there just across the road in the next building. Wherever you're watching, you're welcome, and we're glad that you were able to join us in some way. I also want to welcome and thank the staff that are sitting here, and I know that there are some staff that are at home watching, and I particularly want to welcome back past teachers who I know there are some at home still watching, and there are some past teachers here that have joined us again tonight, so that's really special. So thank you for being here with us tonight. So I know it's a special day. It's special for you guys, and it's special for us, and it's special for your mums and dads, and for all the teachers and the staff of our school here. Children, what a year it's been. And we've talked a bit about that, we've sung about it, we've written songs about it. We've done lots of things about remote learning, about the type of year that we've endured. So what I have to say is that you need to be very, very proud of yourselves, because we are. We're extremely proud of what you've done and for successfully making it through what has probably been the most challenging year ever. Not just for you, but for all of us. So well done to all of you. I know you're excited. You should be. We're excited for you. So to the families out there, wherever you are in the camera world, congratulations to you all. So you should know that the support that we've gotten from you all these years, all through the years that you've been at Donvale Primary School with your children, have made an enormous impact. I'm sure you're very proud of your children too as they close this portion of their lives and prepare for the next steps into secondary school. So to the many teachers and the staff members that we have here and those again who are watching, and to all of them that have played a part in the education of you guys, in the education of these students, I thank you for all your tireless work in providing them with such outstanding teaching, outstanding guidance, your nurturing and your care. You're truly remarkable educators. Thank you. So Year 6 students, you've been the leaders of our school for this year, where we've particularly reflected on your further development of resilience and understood it as simply about a readiness to cope. Well, this year has certainly been the year to practice your readiness to cope. Well, it's my hope that you do feel ready to cope with this big transition, because you're off to secondary school now and you're going to have to cope with new routines, new teachers and the classmates of secondary school. I actually feel very confident that you are ready. And thanks to the very good work of Mr. Reiter, Mr. Tapper, Mrs. Thomas, and Miss Wernert, and of all the other teachers that have taught you across the years, they've all prepared you very well. I've seen the great leadership you've shown throughout the year, both at school and with your remote learning at home. I got to see you manage yourselves relatively independently with your own learning. These are all very good signs, children, that you're ready for all of the new challenges that you face next year. So tonight's also a night for the parents to ask themselves if they're ready. Ask them the big question. Are you going to be able to cope with the big transition ahead for your child and for you? So traditionally, principals, and I've often stood out here in front of graduations, and I've asked parents to pull the reins in, let go a little bit of your children, let take a step back, but not anymore, not tonight. In fact, I'm going to say the opposite to your parents' children. What I want you to do, and what I'd like to dissuade you of, is that mindset where you say this is the time more so now for you to hold on to your children and step up your parenting. Adolescents need active and courageous parenting more than in any previous years. I encourage you to remain profoundly interested in your child's friends, especially their online friends. Engage actively with their learning and remain firm in your modelling of values and ethics to your son or daughter. Whilst primary and secondary schools do their best, teaching of behavioural practices will mostly come from the home. So if you want your Year 7 child to develop strong positive values, then you need to explicitly talk about them and model them to your adolescent. Your 12 and 13-year-olds are unlikely to admit this to, but you are still their superheroes. Adolescents are malleable, and while they are in formation of their future life, you want to make sure your influence does not stop with your genetic inheritance. Nurturing and modelling are your great parental privileges. Used well, they will enrich your life as much as your child's. So children, for you guys, if there's one piece of advice that I would love to be able to super glue right here on your forehead, so that it was front and centre of your thinking for possibly the next 6 years of your schooling, is that would be to protect your good name and your reputation. It's a slow process to build your reputation up, but it can be lost in a moment. I therefore urge you to be constantly aware of your own dignity and of your precious individuality. Don't easily give away what you will never get back. Protect your name, protect your reputation, as it would be your most prized possession. A good name is going to open many doors, both while you are at school and beyond. On the other hand, if you have a poor reputation, it will stay with you and restrict you in ways you may never be aware of until the damage is done. That's particularly now with social media and its capacity to record for posterity every foolish decision that you might make. So right from the beginning of Year 7, start about purposefully building up a good reputation with your family, your classmates, your teachers and other significant people in your community. It's actually not a hard thing to do. It's really, really very easy. Just be kind. It's the best reputation to have, and it far outlives any short-term fame based on what you look like or what your achievements may be. Be sincere. A reputation of being false will damage your credibility. Don't try to be too cool. I know some often try to be that cool kid. You're better off using up that energy in just being out there and being a good friend. Be honest. Be genuine, be truthful, lying and deceiving will always come back around to haunt you later on down the track. Be positive. The world is so much better when you look on the bright side, and help illuminate the good in yourself and in the others with humour and your optimism. Be encouraging of others. If you want the best for others, people will recognise this fine quality and reciprocate it for you. So in conclusion, let me please thank each of you for the great life and leadership you have provided to the primary school community. You are a talented and compassionate group of young people with a very bright future ahead. I've been very proud to know many of you since you started in Foundation in 2013. You're no longer quite as cute as those little kids we saw on the morphing video, but you're just as unique and you're very, very precious. So I want you to enjoy your celebrations tonight. Let Mum and Dad take lots of photos for you, because one day you're going to look back at that and think about how wonderful your time was at primary school. I want you to spend the last days of primary school in gratitude to your teachers and all the other staff here at the school. I want you to heal any difficult relationships, and above all, I'd love you to make some really big plans for your future. Thank you.
This almost brings us to the end of the formalities. Before we finish up, we'd like to thank our teachers, Mr. Ryder, Ms. Thomas, Mr. Tapper, Ms. Werner, and Mrs. Luchizano, for all their help and support in putting this evening together. They are an incredible bunch of teachers, and tonight could not have happened without them. So thank you.
We'd also formally like to thank Mrs. Clark and Mr. McKinley, who played a huge part in making tonight's events happen.
We know that not all schools were able to have a graduation, so we're especially grateful to you.
We'd also like to thank the hard-working parents, particularly those on the graduation committee, who worked so hard to put all of this together. You guys in here didn't get to see the GP room, but we can assure you that it looked absolutely amazing. We all enjoyed a delicious dinner and a lovely dessert, cooked by Caroline Holland. Thanks, Caroline. It was amazing. Without the help of parents, there is no way we could pull all of this together. So a sincere thank you to all of you.
We'd like to thank the staff who have helped out by ushering, taking photos, and doing all the little extra things that have made tonight run so smoothly. We know that you are not obligated to be here or do any of these extra jobs, but you do it anyway, and that makes us feel really special, so thank you.
We'd also like to give our personal thanks to Tam for helping us learn our dances and making sure tonight was a spectacular event, and to Kerry for making us sound awesome when we sing.
Finally, we'd like to thank Alex Lochizano, Nick, and the rest of the team at ALBS Broadcasting, who have filmed and streamed tonight's event. It's been a year like no other, and to be able to share our night with families and friends is something we wouldn't have been able to do without the kindness and hard work of these guys. Thanks to you, we will be able to cherish these memories for the rest of our lives, and we can't thank you enough.
To finish the night, the students are invited to stay for a photo booth and disco, and the families are invited to take photos and view the posters, memory books, and graduation bears around the building. The evening will conclude at 10 p.m. and we ask that everyone head home by that time. We hope you enjoyed tonight's ceremony and that you enjoy one final performance from us.
Even when I'm knocking you down, your heart's weak.
the graduation graphic up and go to a close.
Okay, thank you everybody. We are now going to invite all of the parents from all of the grades and families to come back to the senior building. We have our graduation posters and bears and memory books in the classrooms for you to look at. You can grab photos with your students and talk to your teachers. So our evening will conclude with a photo booth and a disco for you guys. So you are going to be in my room where the photo booth is. That's just for the staff and the students only due to density limits. Another big thank you to the guys at ALBS. We have loved broadcasting the night to you guys. There will be a downloadable link for you to download tonight and made available probably during the week. We'll make that available to you and you can download it to keep forever. Thanks once again. Have a great night, everyone.